Hello friends, welcome to Aasaan IAS. Hope you are enjoying the program Transform into an IAS Officer in 100 Days. Friends, if you can believe, you may start. But if you can understand, you will achieve. You know, environment is a very important module. Now we will talk about environment related organizations. 10th question. So this 10th question we expect from environment related organizations. It is very easy topic. Broadly yaad rakhna aapne, you can answer the question very easily. What you need to understand is only two things. One is whether it is an NGO or it is related to any some other important organization. This is what you need to know. Second, what they do. Generally what they do you can understand from the name itself. Third, if they do any unique thing, then we remember what is that. Other than that, nothing else to remember. Like first, let us start with the organizations related to United Nations, UNEP, United Nations Environment Program. So UNEP is an organ of United Nations. Headquarters at Nairobi, established in 1972. You see, year of establishment and headquarters, choti exam mein pooch sakta hai, not in IAS. So it's important publication. Publications yaad rakhenge, its publication is Global Environmental Outlook. Pooch sakta hai, rare case mein, Global Environmental Outlook is published by. Answer is UNEP. It is a member of UNDP, United Nations Development Program. Even it is one of the implementing agency of GEF, Global Environment Facility, which is a fund. So UNEP is one of the partner of that. But no need to know all the things. It sets global environmental agenda, promotes the coherent implementation of the environmental dimension of sustainable development. You see, it looks after environment broadly, nothing to take out of it. Don't mug up as it is. WMO, World Meteorological Organization. It is also an agency of United Nations, headquarters at Geneva, established in 1950. WMO provides a framework for international cooperation in the development of meteorology and operational hydrology and their practical application. Don't mug up as it is. So it takes care of the atmosphere and all that. So it is responsible for global atmospheric watch. IPCC, International Panel on Climate Change. So WMO and UNEP together have formed it, IPCC. Headquarters at Geneva, established in 1988. It provides policymakers with regular assessments of the scientific basis of climate change, its impacts and future risk and options for adaptation and mitigation. So climate change kitna aur kharab ho raha hai, waisa cheeze batata rahega. So nothing to take out of it. Broadly samajh lijiye, aap aaram se questions attempt kar sakte hai. Then we will talk, whatever now I discuss, all these organizations are NGOs. Only those three you remember. Other than those three, whatever I am discussing are NGOs. First we will talk about IUCN. IUCN kya hai? Ek NGO hai. So International Union on Conservation of Nature. Headquarters at Gland, Switzerland. No need to remember. Established in 1948. Its important publication is Red Data Book. Also called Red List. Which contains lists of threatened plant and animal species. So IUCN runs thousands of field projects around the world to better manage natural environment. So it also look after the environment. Generally NGOs kya karega? Field level pe jaake, local population se milke, they do their work. Then we'll talk about BirdLife International. What is BirdLife International? It is also an NGO. Headquarters in Cambridge, UK mein, 1922 mein it was established. Publication is World Bird Watch. It is a global partnership of conservation organizations. We both NGOs ka global partnership hai. Like India mein bhi iska ek partner hai, BNHS, Bombay Natural History Society. So it is a global partnership of conservation organizations that strives to conserve birds, their habitats and global biodiversity, working with the people towards sustainability in the use of natural resources. Broadly samajh lijiye. So BNHS is its partner and it provides bird data for Red List. Red List mein all threatened species list hota hai, usme birds ka information will be given by BirdLife International. Then we will talk about Worldwide Fund for Nature, WWF. It is also an NGO. Its headquarters is in Switzerland, Gland, and 1961 it was established. Its important publication is Living Planet Report. And it has a unique program initiative that WWF organizes. It organizes something called Earth Hour. What is Earth Hour? It is to turn off non-essential lights for 1 hour from 8:30 PM to 9:30 PM towards the end of March. March mein ek din, second half of March, ek din decide karega every year. All the global mein almost 7,000 cities mein it will be worked. They switch off their lights. Why to do that? To inspire individuals from these cities across the globe to take a stand against climate change. Broadly samajh lijiye, Earth Hour is a unique initiative of WWF. Then we talk about traffic. Traffic is formed by IUCN and WWF. IUCN, WWF, ye dono NGOs ka joint program hai traffic. Headquarters in Cambridge, established in 1976, working globally on trade in wild animals and plants in the context of both biodiversity conservation and sustainable development. So, ve thoda trade pe work karega, like, you know, illegal trade and all, but it is just an NGO. Hope you are understanding. So, it works in close cooperation with the Secretariat of CITES. You know, CITES, Convention on International Trade on Endangered Species. Iske saath milke bhi kaam karega. Because both are doing similar kind of work. Hope you have understood. Very broadly samajh lijiye. Now we will see more NGOs. Wetland International. It is also an NGO. It also works at field level with local people to develop and mobilize knowledge. So obviously Wetland International, so its purpose is to conserve the wetlands. Established in 1995, headquarters in Netherlands. Conservation International. It is also an NGO. You know, mega diverse countries are recognized, are listed under by this Conservation International. Similarly, the concept of biodiversity hotspots is Conservation International concept. And Ocean Health Index is its publication. Established in 1987, headquarters in Arlington, Virginia. Then we will see more NGOs. We'll talk about CGIAR. So it is a global partnership that unites organizations engaged in research for a food secure future. Generally we agriculture and better practices. Us pe jo kaam kar raha hai, us organizations ko we represent karta hai. Matlab it is a partnership of those organizations. Iske andar there are so many institutions. They work at different fields. NGO hai. So headquarter Montpellier and France mein 1971 mein it was established. So CGIAR research is dedicated to reducing rural poverty, increasing food security, improving human health and nutrition, and ensuring sustainable management of natural resources. So just understand the wide area kis pe kaam kar raha hai. Then we talk about IWMI, International Water Management Institute. So obviously it is to take care of water, NGO. It is a member of CGIAR also. Headquarters in Colombo, Sri Lanka. Established in 1985. Member of CGIAR. Like IWMI, CGIAR has many members. IWMI works in water related issues. Something else works somewhere else. CGIAR is partner of all the things. So scientific research organization focusing on the sustainable use of water and land resources in developing countries. Then we will talk about Friends of the Earth International. Friends of the Earth International is also an NGO, so its headquarters is in Amsterdam, Netherlands, and established in 1969. Publication, The Meat Atlas. Now we talk about 350.org. It is also an NGO, and Oakland mein iska headquarters hai. 2007 mein it was established. What is its purpose? You see, in the atmosphere, CO2 levels have increased 400 ppm se badh gaya hai. Now this organization want to put pressure on the world leaders to address climate change and to bring back that CO2 levels in the atmosphere below 350 parts per million. Finally, we will see more BNHS. It is an NGO in India. Though it is an NGO, generally NGOs, what they do, they take donations. But it organizes some camps and nature trails. Ve logon ko kahi gumane mein leke jata hai and they charge money for that. So that they do. And it is very old, established in 1883. It is a partner of BirdLife International also in India. Headquartered in Mumbai. Then Greenpeace. Greenpeace is also an NGO. Issue with India. It was into news 2 years back. Because India ka jo economic development ka ye bar bar beech mein rok raha hai. Like by putting environment karab ho jayega ye karke sare projects ko beech mein rok raha hai. So Indian government has stopped their accounts saying that they are misusing the funds and all. So there was issue. We don't go deep into that. Just understand Greenpeace ek NGO hai. Established in 1971. Headquarters in Amsterdam, Netherlands. Plant Life International kya hai? Ye bhi ek NGO hai. Works with partner organizations around the world who are conserving their important plant areas. Us pe kaam karega. Established in 1989, headquarter in Wiltshire, UK. So don't remember establishment years. Don't remember the headquarters. Just remember which is NGO, which is organ of United Nations. Then broadly understand what they do. All of them do something in related to environment. Nothing more you require. स्पेशल प्रोग्राम्स माइंड में रखिए, पब्लिकेशंस माइंड में रखिए. Now you see, you can answer any question. Like there was a question in 2014. Consider the following statements regarding Earth Hour. It is an initiative of UNEP and UNESCO. You know, Earth Hour is an initiative of WWF. If you know that, you can say one is wrong. If you know one is wrong, A and D are eliminated. Now you see, it is a movement in which the participants switch off the lights for 1 hour on a certain day every year. Which is correct? It is a movement to raise the awareness about the climate change and need to save the planet, which is also correct. Generally, this kind of statements, when it explains what it do, generally he won't make wrong. Hope you understand. So both are correct. C, the answer. It is a special program, that's why we remember. Now you see general questions, like there was a question in 2015 with reference to International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources, IUCN, and the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora, CITES, which of the following statements is correct? CITES ke baare mein hum species ki topic mein padhenge. So IUCN is an NGO. First you see, IUCN is an organ of United Nations. Even without knowing anything, if you see this much, you can say one is wrong. So if you know one is wrong, you can say A is wrong, C is wrong, D is wrong. See how silly questions come in the exam. You just want to check. You see, in terms of whether it is an organ of UN or not, yaha galat banane ka chance hai. What they do generally will not be wrong. For example, you see second statement. IUCN runs thousands of field projects around the world to better manage natural environments. Agar ek galat hoga, toh sahi statement kya hoga? So this kind of statements he generally cannot make wrong. Similarly, CITES is legally binding on the states that have joined it, but this convention does not take the place of national laws. It is correct. Anyway, this we will talk in species topic. Hope you understand. So both are correct. A question again from 2015. With reference to an organization known as World Life International, which of the following statements is correct? It is a global partnership of conservation organizations. Yes, it is correct. The concept of biodiversity hotspots originated from this organization. If you remember, biodiversity hotspots are declared by Conservation International, and it is the concept of Norman Meyer who introduced the concept. So it has nothing to do with World Life International. So second is wrong. If you know that, you can eliminate B and D. One is correct. And three, it identifies the sites known, referred to as important bird and biodiversity areas. Even if you do not know, such statements cannot be wrong. This is a general statement. So you cannot say it does not identify, something else identify. Even he is talking about important bird and biodiversity areas. So it is correct. 1 and 3 are correct. C, the answer. Take this question asked in 2017. Consider the following statements in respect of trade related analysis of fauna and flora in commerce. Traffic ki baat kar raha hai. Traffic is a bureau under United Nations Environment Program. Traffic is made by IUCN and WWF. It is not under UNEP. UNEP is an organ of UN, and WWF and IUCN are NGOs. So this is wrong. The mission of traffic is to ensure that trade in wild plants and animals is not a threat to the conservation of nature. Aisa statement generally galat nahi hota hai, and it is correct. So B, the answer. Hope you have understood. Take this question asked in 2014. With reference to a conservation organization called Wetland International, which of the following statements is correct? It is an intergovernmental organization. You see, Wetland International is just an NGO, not an intergovernmental organization. So one is wrong. And formed by countries which are signatories to Ramsar Convention. It has nothing to do with Ramsar Convention. Of course, it is one of the partner of Ramsar Convention, but it is an NGO. Second, it works at the field level to develop and mobilize knowledge and use the practical experience to advocate for better policies. Aisa statement galat nahi hota hai. Generally, you know, NGOs work at field level to do these kind of things. So second is correct, first is wrong. B, the answer. A question asked in 2014, with reference to Bombay Natural History Society, consider the following statements. It is an autonomous organization under the Ministry of Environment and Forest. You see, it is just an NGO. It has nothing to do with the ministry. So one is wrong. If you know one is wrong, you can eliminate A and D. It strives to conserve nature through action-based research, education and public awareness. Aisa statement galat nahi hota hai. Kyunki generally NGOs, they create awareness and all this kind of thing. It is a very common statement. So second is correct. Third, it organizes and conducts nature trials and camps for the general public. It does. BNHS, if you go, you know, it is the specialty of that. So C, the answer. Hope you have understood. So this is an important topic about organizations. Hope you have understood. Thank you for watching this.